Hi, I'm Mike Yanessa, and I'm doing a new show on PCTV called Car Stories. If you get the PCTV channel, that's great. If you don't, you can go to PCTV on the computer, and you can see my show at any time. So here we are tonight live on High Street at Pottstown Classic Car Club's Cruise Night. The first Saturday of each month, they have this cruise night, and this is a special one because we're here. We're going to interview some people, talk about their cars, and try to get some car stories from my TV show on PCTV. So I hope that everybody gets to watch this on the internet or on the cable. And Pottstown, I'll give you a little history on Pottstown. It was once the cruising capital of the East Coast. Everybody came to Pottstown to cruise. But unfortunately, those days are gone. But the first Saturday of each month, they have a cruise night where everybody brings out their classic cars and displays them. And you know, they have plenty of restaurants open to eat, and it's just a nice family event that I suggest you meet, can come to if you can. The first Saturday throughout the summer, it goes from May until September. The last one is September 1st, and there's a Hot Wheels race for the young kids. So if you have any young kids, bring them out for the Hot Wheels race. My company, Wheels in Motion, sponsors the race. The car behind me is a 59 Impala that I recently got on the road. It was sitting for a long time, and it's an original paint car with 34,000 miles, and it's just a real joy to drive and a real beauty. But tonight, the Pottstown Classic Car Club, through their donations that they receive, it costs $10 to park your car on High Street, but with that money, it goes to charity. It goes to Meals on Wheels. It goes to various local organizations, and also it went to a project, a 1967 Ford Galaxy that was through the efforts of Pottstown Classic Car Club. It was restored and repainted and running, and tonight they're going to hand the keys over to Brad Heron. He's a war veteran. He was in Afghanistan. He was in Iraq. He was at Katrina. So it's a special night here at High Street in downtown Pottstown. So I hope that you tune in, like I said, on the internet or on the cable and watch these shows and bring me your stories. Wheelsinmotion@AOL.com is my email. Email me your stories about local stories of Pottstown, cruising, car clubs, racing, any old story. So that's all for now, and I'll see you in a couple minutes.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, get around, round, round, I get around, I get around.
Okay, so here we are on High Street at the Pottstown Classic Cruise Night. And what do we find? We find a vintage 1969 Camaro Grandview car called the Pink Panther. Obviously, you can see the Pink Panther is pink, and the mascot is right in front of it. And this is Tom Herbert and his brother, and they worked on this car and raced this car at Grandview back in the late 70s till the early 80s, and he did some phenomenal things with it. He had some unique engineering tricks, and he was a very good racer. So you see hot rods, you see Corvettes, you see Ford, Chevys, and you see old race cars on High Street in downtown Pottstown. So Tom Herbert is going to talk for a few minutes about this special car.
Hi, Mike. Thanks for having me. Yes, this car, particular car, we chose to restore because it had the most wins, and I also won most popular driver that year. So it was our best hand-built, and it did have a lot of tricks. It had bird cages when the rule book said no bird cages, but it didn't say I didn't have real bird cages, but they didn't say I had to weld everything together.
Okay.
Okay. It had tall spindles in the front for better front geometry.
Right.
I went down south to learn my knowledge. Follow the leader, that's what they did. So I wanted to win races, so I came up with my own tricks to beat them. And this was a great car for that.
Right. It's a beautiful car, Tom. You did a great job restoring it. Tom would come into the shop from time to time and talk to me about the car because of the he needed some little parts and stuff for a 69 Camaro, and it took him, what, a couple years to get it together?
Yeah, Gary and I worked on this. We got this car August of 09, dumped in our front yard. And if you'd only see what we started to start with, you wouldn't believe that you're looking at the same car.
Right.
All right? It's got a floor out of a 94 Tahoe. You know, it's a accumulation of all my racing knowledge. The original car had drum brakes. This has discs.
Right, right. A lot of the parts, though, are from the original car.
Yeah.
The motor and rear and stuff like that, which is so cool.
Yes.
I'm so glad that you took the time to do it.
I mean, it's unique.
Yep.
I mean, and that's another reason we did it. And we actually started out to build a nostalgic race car.
Right.
But it ended up like this, so... Here we are.
No, very good.
Booby Nation, we help attract attention to their cause.
Right.
Their breast cancer cause. And,
right.
And, you know, we have a good relationship there.
Yep.
We do kind of try to hook up as much as we can.
Right.
And people listen to it. When I fire it up, they want to know what size V8's in it.
Yeah, right, right. That six-cylinder really sounds loud.
Yes, there's no mufflers, short pipes.
Right.
And
see, a lot of these cars, folks, people always tied in with a good cause, like Booby Nation and different things. That's the great thing about this hobby. It's not always about the car. It's about what it represents to help people that are less fortunate. And that's really cool, Tom.
Thank you.
Great job.
Thank you.
All right. Here's another beautiful classic car, a 1932 Ford with a blown Chevy small block under the hood. So it gets up and goes. This is Blaine Grebe. He built this car a while ago, he'll tell you when, with his son, Joey Grebe, and it still looks beautiful. Denny's Corvette Restos painted it a number of years ago, and it's just a unique car that's regular here on High Street at the Pottstown Classic Car Club Cruise Nights. So Blaine's going to tell you a little bit about building the car and share a story with you. Another great car story.
Well, we picked the car up in 1989. I was out of street rods for a while, and Joey come home and told me, he said he found a 32 for sale. That was it. We were back into street rods again. So it was 89 when we bought it.
Wow.
And it was 95 when we got it on the road.
Wow.
Like you said, Denny Corvette did the paint job, chopped the top 3.5 inches. It's all steel. No fiberglass.
Wow, it's all steel.
All
That's
steel.
Great.
9-inch Ford rear. Disc brakes all the way around. Power windows and door locks.
And what's that color, Blaine? Do you remember?
Magenta.
That's off Geo Storm.
Ah, it's just perfect for the car.
And the frame is powder coated, and that was a magenta color too. You know, on their
colors. Yeah,
but they come out different, but. You know, it's still it's all right, you know.
It's beautiful. It's very unique.
I had a lot of fun with it, but...
Good.
Well, as you know, since I have the pickup, I spend more time running the pickup than I do this.
Yep, you'll find a lot of the car people have more than one classic car, and Blaine also has a, 35 Ford pickup, and that one's not shiny. It's kind of just a flat primer like they did in the old days. So this is a shiny one, and his flat one's at home. Actually, it's at my shop. We were working on it for him.
Carburetors.
So another beautiful car here in downtown Pottstown. Thank you, Blaine. Okay, here we are now with Brian Heinze. He owns Stanley Steamer Carpet Cleaner up in Stowe, and he's a big help in the Pottstown Classics. And they got something new here on High Street that's a little bit of a challenge for some of the mechanics that want to be. So I'll let Brian tell you what this is all about, that this car here with the wheels on it.
This is a NASCAR pit challenge, changing the tires. All right, we're timing you. You take a tire off, put a tire on, the fastest time Right now, the senior group is 31 seconds. All right. At the end of the day, the fastest time gets a $25 gift certificate at the Brick House.
Wow.
And the junior group gets a $10 gift certificate up there at the ice cream shop.
Oh, that's really nice. Good idea.
Goes to the car club to help support the Classic Car Club.
Right. See, that's another. Here we go again. More donations that goes to a good cause. Yeah, that's what this club's all about. And Brian mentioned the Brick House. That's a big restaurant on High Street here. Very good. And the ice cream place is what? Do you remember the name?
Sweet Hot.
A side of Very Best. There's a lot of new eateries here on High Street. If you haven't been out for a while, check it out. Look at the pretty cars. Take your wife out to dinner and make a night of it. Okay, here we are again with another beautiful little car. My shop, Wheels in Motion, which I talked about on the show, we're doing a Rambler Scrambler, which was a special Rambler that was painted red, white, and blue. They only made a few hundred of them, and it was a 390 four-speed hot rod version. But what we have here is the six-cylinder, just a nice restoration on this old Rambler. It's a 1964, and it's beautiful. George works here at a local business in Pottstown. I see him from time to time, and he's going to tell you a little bit about the car. George?
Hi, my name's George. I live locally in Stowe, right outside of town. And I saw this car sitting in Malvern about 5 years ago, and that's all it was doing was sitting. And they painted it about 2 years later, and then it sat for a couple of more years. And I'm from Kenosha, Wisconsin, where it was built. So I just had to ask the woman if she wanted to sell it, and we got together on a price. And I've enjoyed having it and detailing it since then. And
it looks beautiful, George. I mean, it really does.
We're getting a lot of enjoyment out of it.
Very good. See, it's not just about hot rods and Corvettes and Cobras. The regular plain cars that you just don't see anymore like this. They're beautiful. They're work of art. So all kind of cars here on Pottstown High Street. George is also a member of the Pottstown Classic Car Club. He's here at every one just about. And again, that's what makes this town special. Wow, we're walking down High Street. We're looking for another car to do a story on. We saw Tony Zimba. We saw Paulie Zimba. And if you remember, I was talking about a 40 Willys that sat on a rollback trailer on Charlotte Street when I was about 5 years old. Tony Zimba is walking up, so we stopped to talk to Tony. Tony was a drag racer back in the 60s, a well-known car guy. You want to talk about car stories between this whole family. Like I said, we could do a whole season on the Zimba family. So, Tony, it was so nice to see you here on High Street.
Yeah, glad you stopped by.
Yep, how is the old Willys?
Well, it's just about ready for paint.
Oh,
we
good.
Got it all back together, and I just had a little slight delay with my wife having a stroke.
Yeah,
otherwise
I would
have had it all done.
She's okay now?
She's pretty good. Yeah, she's coming around great.
Well, I can't wait to see that old Willys back again. Shiny red again, or what color?
Yeah, it'll be red. Yeah, I got the paint and everything for it, and it's ready
well,
to go.
Well, we're going to have to come back to High Street when Tony gets the Willys done and do another show, Gus.
Thanks, Tony.
Okay, walking down High Street, I wanted to show you this car. It's a 1966 Chevelle. It's owned by Pottstown Classic Car member Brad Ray, and I had the privilege of rebodying and repainting this car last winter. It got new quarter panels, new door skins. It wasn't rusty. The car was just hit a few times, and we wound up putting sheet metal, door skins, fenders on it, and this is one of my favorite cars that I did at Wheels in Motion, the body shop at 346 Jefferson Avenue. The color is marina blue. It's a correct color for a 66 Chevelle. Brad, picked this color out of many other choices that we had for him, and it just suits the car right. It's a beautiful automobile. Thank you. A 1959 Corvette. Wow, what a beauty. Wide white walls and all. The white coves, convertible top. I had a 61, and boy, these cars are just the epitome of the American sports car. And a side of it is the other end of the extreme. It's not an original car. It's a hot rod. It's a 1956 Bel Air. two-door sedan with a flip front end. It has B gas written on the front end. That was a class back in the 50s, 60s, that the 70s, that they raced these cars at the drag strip. Big block Chevrolet engine, fuel injected. Look at all the baseballs. That's in the end of the injector, so no dirt will get in there. Of course, when they get the car running, they pull those balls out. Fender well headers, self-explanatory. They come out through the fenders. The green tinted glass, something from the 60s that, you know, is just awesome on this car. The Big Daddy tack, that's a red, white, and blue tack on the dashboard. It was signed by Don Garlitz. He's the one that made it famous, red, white, and blue. And again, you never know what you're going to see here on High Street in downtown Pottstown. 56 Chevy, beautiful car. Okay, here we are on High Street, where we got the color guard, we got motorcycles, and finally, we have the beautiful 1967 Ford Galaxy, restored by various shops in the Pottstown area, and it is be given tonight the keys to Brad Heron, a war veteran, and it's a big improvement. And the last time I saw the car, it looks really good. Check out the kid seat in the back for Brad's kid. There he is, Brad Heron. There's your car.
I just want to thank everybody that was involved in the entire process. I really want to thank my wife, Dina, for reaching out to Pottstown Classics Car Club and for Pottstown Classics Car Club for even going through with this whole project. I mean, it was really a lot. A lot of things that we learned throughout this entire process was that this was a one-year-only vehicle. So all the parts that you see on it either had to be manufactured by hand or found or restored. So it was a very arduous process, but I mean, just they did a tremendous job. Just amazing, absolutely amazing.
Well, I hope you enjoy the car,
absolutely,
Brad. Pottstown Classics did a great job. I'm from PCTV. It's called Car Stories, and this is a great car story.
It is.
All right, so here we are at High Street. Brad Heron just received his car, and Pottstown Classics did a terrific job. Here we have Jim Brennan from Pottstown Classics, and he's going to tell you some information about the car and how it came about. Jim?
Well, Mike, about 2 years ago, we took this project on after a email and phone calls from Brad's wife to for some assistance in redoing her husband's 67 Ford Galaxy. The club, wasting no time, jumped in, decided to take this project on. After a couple road bumps, we got it. But in the last 7 months, we've got this thing rolling pretty good. A lot of great sponsors jumped in to take this project on and get everything going. Mako, Bill jumped in. He volunteered. He said, no problem. Let's get this job done. From January to March, we had that car done in paint at the Oaks Car Show, which was phenomenally, which was a phenomenal task in 2.5 months.
Just to get it there, yeah.
DW Motorsports did all the powder coating. Great job on that. It was hundreds of pieces to get powder coated, sandblasted, cleaned.
Right.
The crew at my shop and all the other guys in the car club that jumped in. Mike's Upholstery. Mike called Mike. Mike said, no problem, bring it down. He'll take care of it. Mike did all the interior work for it, put the vinyl top on it, and just countless other sponsors. Countless other sponsors in the area, charity donations at car shows that we had. Everything was done with funds raised and time and money donated. So,
and if you go on the internet, there's a complete list of the sponsors.
Absolutely, yes.
And
complete.
There's a whole story about the car. You got to read it. So go on the internet and check it out.
Yep, great.
All right, Jim.
Thank you.
That was Jim from Brennan's Auto Repair. He spearheaded a lot of the mechanical finishing on the car. Pottstown High School, they put the motor in. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. I can't even tell you. So go on the internet and check out all the sponsors that made this happen through Pottstown Classic Car Club. Okay, so we just gave Brad Heron the keys to his beautiful 67 Galaxy, And I want to talk to the guy here, Bill, from Pottstown Mako, that put on that shiny red paint. Bill.
How are you?
Yep, how are you?
Very good. We had a really good time doing this. My guys needed something to rally around, and that was really it for us.
Right.
It was a pleasure for us to and an honor for us to do it.
Great. Now you did a great job. It looks good. All shined up.
Thank you very much.
So that was Bill from Pottstown Mako. That's the guy that painted it. Over here is Willie Bertotti, Pottstown High School shop teacher. He was instrumental in some of the mechanical work on the car. About a year ago? At the beginning of the project, they did the motor and transmission, and I'll let him say a few words for you.
Thanks. We jumped into the project. They needed some voluntary work, and students just absolutely loved it. They enjoy working on the old stuff, and it was a real treat and a real pleasure for them to do it. Yeah. And I'm just glad it came out the way it did.
Oh, it looks great. It's great. I'm a graduate of Pottstown High School's auto shop, and it's just a neat thing to see this come from Pottstown. All the people that had their hands in this car, like I said, I can't even begin to cover. So check it out on the web, and you'll get some more of the people that made this project happen. Well, here we are with Tony Zimba, the president of Pottstown Classic Car Club. And you want to talk about car stories. His family could do a complete season of car stories. His dad, when I was a little kid, I used to remember his Willys on the ramp truck sitting on Charlotte Street. And I was like 5 years old seeing that shiny Willys racing at Maple Grove. Tony was in the cars, Paulie Zimba. That's a whole nother season, but he's the president of Pottstown Classic Car Club. He had a lot to do with making this project happen. But Carissa went to school at Willie Bertotti's auto shop at Pottstown High School, and she worked on the car. So it's just so neat that all these people that made this happen, and we're going to interview her, and she's going to tell us, what'd you do to the car?
I helped strip the engine and pull it out.
And clean it up?
Yeah, cleaned out the car and gutted it. So
great. And you're going to follow the automotive career somewhere, work at a local garage, or what's your plans?
I graduated in October, so I plan on continuing my career in a shop, become an inspection mechanic, so I hope I get there.
You will, you will. As long as you want to do it, anything can happen. You know that.
Yep.
So I graduated from Pottstown High School in 1977, so it can happen. You just had to work hard.
Maternity was a big help, so
helped
me through and helped me with joining ATC, so...
How long you had ATC?
I've been there for a year and a half.
So you're close. Good, good.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. Another car story for somebody that helped make this project happen. Okay, folks, our first live shoot on High Street. Hope to be some more in the future. We saw some beautiful cars. We heard some good stories. Giving Brad Heron his 67 Ford Galaxy was a moment that was just so special. So... We talked to a few people, saw a few cars, and had a good time tonight on High Street. The Pottstown Classic Car Club is a great organization. Their money goes to many charities. And my show is called Car Stories. It's on PCTV Live, and it's stories about people's cars. It's that simple. My company is Wheels in Motion. Wheels in Motion has two shops in Pottstown, 26 East 8th Street and 346 Jefferson Avenue. So email me your story at wheelsinmotion@aol.com or give me a call or call PCTV. And I'll be glad to do a story about your car, and we can make this show really take off. So thanks for joining us tonight at the Pottstown Classic Car Club Cruise Night.
Round, round, get around, I get around. Yeah, get around, round, round, I get around.